Morning, everybody. Honorable dignitaries present on the dais, of the dais. At the outset, I thank the organizers to invite me here. I am amongst Lieutenant General D.B. Shekhatkar sahab, then Vice Admiral K.V. Karve sahab, and Bansal sahab just spoke. I'm so happy that for the first time in my life, I am among defense people. And I remembered Shastri ji saying, Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan. I'm representing agriculture and you all are defense people. So it's a very nice combination which I experienced today. So this particular session is basically on coastal community. Coastal community is, you have defined in a way already, has a typical problems. As I joined as a Vice Chancellor, the first question I had to deal was, there are two universities for animal husbandry and this thing. There is a MAPSU, new university formed somewhere in 2002 or 2003. And that time, the local community decided that fishery college, which was present in Ratnagiri, shouldn't go to MAPSU. It should remain with agriculture university. They really thought that the coastal community and the agriculture as such, means the fishery part and the coastal activities and the agriculture on the mainland, at least in the Konkan region, cannot be separated. They are same. I mean, they are so integrated that they should not be different. Maybe in 2019, we made it confirmed. We changed the University Act, saying that the fishery college in Konkan region should remain with Agriculture University. And that was a very important step the government of Maharashtra has taken. And now the fisheries and agriculture in Konkan region is now in hand. So the coastal community, as you rightly said, is not only the people who stay on the coast. They are in that entire Konkan region. Konkan region where the about five districts, right from Tana, Palghar, Raigad, Ratnagiri and Sindhudurg. So all that belt has got a coastal region, coastal area. And in that coastal area, the agriculture is very distinct. And in that distinct agriculture is definitely along with the where the mainland people and the coast people work hand in hand. So we are discussing basically today, our entire discussion is based on those communities. I was a student in the same university, maybe in 70s, and we used to have a student run cafeteria or mess there. And I was secretary, so I was managing the day-to-day activities, just like any other mess secretary. I remember, I'm telling this story because I used to go on a corner of the road where at 10 o'clock, one truck used to come. In that truck backside, lot of fisher women used to get fish in baskets. And we used to buy fish from them. So moment the truck arrives, we used to climb up on the truck. We used to choose a good fish basket and used to purchase. So we used to see all those fisherwomen. After about, I mean, this was in 70s, 1970s. And 1919 I went there. And I again saw the same thing happen. So even after so many years, the fisherwomen are saying, they are still bringing those baskets, and morning when their men go to the sea to catch the fish comes on the coast, they are picked by these ladies, and those ladies come and market. The entire marketing is done by them. Why I am saying this, if you go in many other coastal regions where the fishing business is very organized, we were discussing with my colleague today morning itself that this business is very well organized in many coastal regions. But in India, the fact is same. If you go across the Konkan region, you will find that that fisherwoman sitting on the side of the roadside somewhere, keeping the fish on the ice flakes and other things. So there is not much of change has occurred. Even the technologies have changed. Our ship, our fisheries purposes, vessels have changed, and many other things have come. But the fish marketing, which decides the economy of those people, is still the same. Not much outstanding processing of fish is happening, even though a lot of technologies are there. So we should be, today you are talking about those things is a very good thing. Another thing is that it's a high rainfall area. The entire Sahyadri belt, basically, not much agriculture can be done there except growing up a little bit of paddy. That's why all people from this area move towards cities like Pune, Bombay and whatnot. And that's the reason the field agriculture is by and large is very badly neglected. Nowadays you find the paddy cultivation is no more very economical. And there is no concept of what you call commercial agriculture in that area. People come there, we call them as Chakarmani, means the resident of the Konkan region or in the coastal region go to the cities to earn money, and that is why they are Chakarmani. And then they come back only during festivals like Holi or Ganapati or Diwali and all that, or they may come sometimes to grow their paddy. They bring seed from somewhere, grow seeds, and they do paddy transplanting, go back, and the paddy again is ready for harvest, they harvest it in. So there is no commercial concept of agriculture there as a dominant concept. It is okay, my grandson or my son, if I am able to give you one bag full of rice or some other agriculture products on the very big occasion of the that should be my requirement. So that has to come. That commercial concept of agriculture. Commercial agriculture, nowadays we are talking about, if I have to stop people going for a job outside, there should be agri-entrepreneurship developed into that area where people do commercial agriculture. And that commercial agriculture is good enough, should be good enough to make people stay there, so that in other words their earning should be almost comparable to their jobs in the cities. Unless until we do that, people will not come there and really stay. So that's very, very important from my viewpoint.